My name's Anna Stevens, and I was an assistant producer on the Life and Death Row series. There had been a poll of sort of young people, and it showed that actually more than 50% of young people at the time of this poll were in favour of bringing back capital punishment in the UK. Now, that is actually quite a shocking statistic, and I think that was the why we went into this series, to make something that would really kind of resonate with young people and make them confront, okay, if you are to have a death penalty system, what does that involve? What does that mean both for perpetrators and victims? And something that would be quite a difficult watch and, you know, make people on both sides of the debate question what they believe. There is not sort of a hard and fast way of doing access, and we were often approaching people who were victims of horrific crimes or who were families of people that were facing execution. And, you know, to make those sort of phone calls is an incredibly difficult thing. Often we would make the approaches by letter. We would often make approaches first to solicitors or to their legal counsel, who would help us to kind of broker that access. For the most part, we found that people were very open to talking about this as a subject because they tended to have really strong feelings on one side or other.
Some of Texas's brightest students are signing up for an extreme law course. They'll be trying to save killers on death row.
The reason that we actually filmed with the University of Houston is it happens to be one of the absolute busiest that there is, probably, you know, countrywide, and they just found that, you know, virtually all of the cases facing execution in Texas would come through them at some point. So, you know, what we found there was a really strong team. I think that the idea that young people and young law students were working on cases that were very harrowing and doing a lot of the legwork and actually taking a real kind of role in the legal proceedings was really interesting to us coming from the UK, because it was far more hands-on than anything that you might get as a law student here.
We are going to go visit Marcia Pruitt, which is Robert Pruitt's mother. She lives in the Fifth Ward of Houston.
The casting process was in some ways limited by the legal process. So because we were filming ongoing, you know, trials and appeals and, you know, people that were kind of facing execution, you are inevitably in some way led in the casting process by, you know, the stories that are happening in your timeline. So that was very much a job for me and the other assistant producer, was to find everything that was likely to happen or to conclude over the year that we were making this series, and of them to find the very strongest contributors and stories that we could. We began following the story of Robert Pruitt, and two students were assigned to his case, one of which was Kelly. And we filmed with actually both of them quite equally from the beginning, but it quickly became clear that Kelly was facing her own sort of personal struggles and actually was going on her own journey, and that became very interesting to us throughout the film as well.
Yeah, but you know how I feel, Kelly. If somebody has been convicted, why should they be given any special privileges?
Well, it's not about being given privileges so much as not treating them like animals.
Well, what about the victim?
That she had come from this very conservative background, but yet was suddenly becoming a bit disillusioned with what she thought she believed in, and becoming much more anti-death penalty as the film went on.
You would think that with time it would get easier to kind of deal with it, or at least you learn how to deal with it, but it actually gets worse.
I think it does get worse. You stay here.
I think one of the things that I found with this series is you went into some situations almost slightly unprepared, because we weren't able to have access to do big pre-interviews. We weren't sure exactly how stories were going to play out, and you know, you're never sure how the, you know, legal proceedings are going to play out. So you did really have to think on your feet and stay flexible. And you know, we would do as much research as we could before we went, and we kind of had an idea of where stories would fit within the three episodes, and which kind of stories would be interesting to follow. But it wasn't until you kind of got there and were sitting in front of people that you kind of thought, okay, here is the narrative, here's the story that is going to unfold, and begin to then shape your filming around following kind of one or two particular characters, or, you know, and kind of start shaping it in that way. I think that for a series like this, that one of the biggest strengths that you can bring to a team is the ability to find contributors, but also to maintain relationships with people. And you know, you can get all of the technical skills that you like in terms of shooting, but actually it's relationships that are the key to being able to make films like this. Maintaining that relationship for, you know, months afterwards, as we go through the editing process, as the film goes out, and often they're not entirely prepared for how difficult it is to see their stories on screen. And I think that that's one of the really important things, is just being able to, you know, really maintain those relationships with people and put a lot of energy into making sure that people are kind of informed and are comfortable at every step of the journey. And I think that's how, you know, amazing series like these are made.